In the previous parts, we fed ArcSWAT with all the information related to the study area where we implemented the commands in the ArcSWAT menu bar, which included the SWAT project setup menu, watershed delineator, HRU analysis, write input tables, and edit SWAT input. In this part, we will implement the sixth menu command from the ArcSWAT menu bar, which is SWAT simulation, and in it we press on run SWAT a window entitled Setup and Run SWAT Model Simulation appears, and in it we go to Period of Simulation and we choose Starting Date 1-1-2000 and Ending Date 31-7-2014. It should be noted that in the case of selecting the date for the years prior to the year 2000, it may lead to an error in implementation. So it is preferable that the start date be from 1-1-2000 and above. Then we go to SWAT.exe version, in which we choose 64-bit release according to the Windows systems. Then we go to the print out settings and we choose daily, and in NYSKIP we choose 3. Then we click on Setup SWAT Run. Then a message appears indicating that finished SWAT setup. Then we press OK. Then we click on Run SWAT. Implementation starts for the successive years and as we see, and a message appears indicating that SWAT runs successful. Then we click OK and close the window. Then we go to the sixth menu titled SWAT Simulation, and in it we choose Read SWAT Output. A window entitled SWAT Output appears, and in it we go to check output fields to import, and we tick all the options. in the output.rsv option, if there is no reservoir in the study area, we do not tick it. And since in this project we have reservoirs, then we tick it and the rest of the options. Then we click on import files to database. We wait for implementation. Then a message appears indicating that done writing file to database, then we press OK. Then we click on Run SWAT check. A window titled SWAT Error Checker appears, and in it we press Examine Model Output, then Analysis starts. The results appear in the simulation details as we see. And we follow up the rest of results where we go to the hydrology menu, which contains water balance for the study area. Then we go to sediment menu that contains the sediment results for the study area. Then we go to the nitrogen cycle menu where we check messages of warning. Then we go to phosphorus cycle menu and we check out the messages of warning. Then we go to the plant growth menu and in it we check messages of warning. Then we go to the landscape neutronic losses menu, and in it we check messages of warning. Then we go to the land use summary menu, and in it we check messages of warning. Then we go to in-stream processes menu, in which we check messages of warning. Then we go to point source menu, and in it we check messages of warning. Then we go to reservoirs menu, and in it we check messages of warning. Then we go to the about menu, the SWAT error check process ends and no error appear, where we see a green check mark on it, and we close the window. Then we go to save SWAT simulation, and we type the name of saving SIM2. Then we click on save simulation. A message appears indicating that SWAT run successfully, save it as SIM2. Then we press OK and we close the window. To preview the simulation results of ArcSWAT program for the study area, we go to the project file on the desktop. Entitled SWAT project, and in it we open the ArcGIS file entitled SWAT project.mdb. Which contains the data entered into the project, as we see. As for the simulation results in ArcSWAT, we find them here inside this file entitled Scenarios, in which we open the file that contains simulation results in ArcSWAT, and it is titled SIM2, and in it we open the file titled Tables Out, and in it we open the ArcGIS file titled SWAT Output.mdb, and it contains the simulation results in ArcSWAT, as we see. where in the table titled RC Edge, we find the values of flow in and flow out in days from 2003 to 2014, which are for 7 subbasins in the study area, as we see in subfield, where if we want to preview the results of flow in and flow out for certain subbasin, let it be subbasin 4, we make left click on subfield and tick subbasin 4 only. Then we press OK. Then the flow in and the flow out in subbasin 4 appear. Then we close the access file. And we go to ArcMap and we save the project by pressing on save. Thus, we have completed the implementation of the project in ArcSWAT, which includes the calculation of daily discharges in the riverbeds of the study area basin, the sediment calculation, and other calculations in ArcSWAT.